Hello racing fans, this is NASCAR Racing Fan 2015 back with some more 2019 silly season news to cover. The pieces of the puzzle are starting to fit, and that includes the 2019 roster for Front Row Motorsports. It was announced last week that Matt Tifft will drive the number 36 Ford Mustang, which this third team was acquired from the BK Racing sale just last summer. In addition, the number 34 and number 38 teams will once again be driven by Michael McDowell and David Reagan, respectively. Crew chief pairings as well as sponsors for the teams have yet to be announced. So the early days of Matt Tifft were just plain mediocre. Driving for powerful race teams such as Kyle Busch Motorsports, Red Horse Racing, and Joe Gibbs Racing, the driver from Ohio had an abysmal track record during that time frame. In 69 NASCAR starts, he had a total 0 wins, 3 top 5s, 28 top 10 finishes, and had an average finish of around 15th.
God! Matt Tifft, you absolute failure of a driver. You can't drive.
In 2018, however, Matt Tifft decided to join Richard Childress Racing and pilot the number 2 Chevrolet Camaro led by crew chief Randall Burnett. As a result, Tifft was able to have a career year on the NASCAR XFINITY Series Tour. Through 33 races, Matt Tifft earned 9 top 5s, 16 top 10 finishes, and improved his average finish by one position, finishing 13th on a consistent basis. This campaign is what changed my stance on Matt Tifft. He was able to put together consistently good results on a weekly basis and even outperformed Brandon Jones, who was driving his number 19 car from last year. Personally, because of the impressive improvement last season, Matt Tifft, in my mind, is very deserving of this promotion at Front Row Motorsports, while he hasn't won a race in NASCAR, which is something I was very critical of RCR for with bringing Daniel Hemric up to the Cup Series. Matt Tifft is a perfect fit for Front Row Motorsports. He is a driver that can consistently get results on the racetrack and can excel on a lower scale. This was something he lacked at JGR, as the spotlight, the need to perform, was always shining on him. As a result, Matt Tifft melted under the pressure. Last season, however, Matt Tifft was able to greatly overachieve and perform at RCR with little to no expectations going forward. That, in my mind, is his greatest strength. By taking over a virtually new race team that was inherited from the BK Racing liquidation sale, it will mean that there are no expectations whatsoever. In my mind, flying under the radar is the best chance for success for Matt Tifft, and this should be a benefit to him driving for a smaller team. In addition, Matt Tifft has a decent group of teammates to build around and become an even better driver on the track. Both Michael McDowell and David Reagan have been veterans of the Cup Series since 2007 and have been models of consistency from the beginning. As a result, Front Row Motorsports had arguably its best season since its inception, as 2018, the combined statistics for Michael McDowell and David Reagan featured 2 top 10 finishes, and they finished 26th and 25th in the point standings, respectively. Only a few positions behind Hendrick Motorsports driver William Byron. The two drivers, as well as the organization itself, they are getting better and are making strides for the future. Unlike Daniel Hemric at RCR, Matt Tifft has a core surrounding around him, and it can help him ease past the struggles as a NASCAR rookie and develop into a seasoned veteran like his predecessors. For Front Row Motorsports, it was necessary to promote a young driver to the Cup Series, as they should do a great job of consistently building towards the future. As for sponsorship, it is looking more and more likely that Tunity and Surface Sunscreen will make the jump to the Cup Series. While his career has been carried on by some sponsorship, I don't consider Tifft a pay driver. If he was truly sponsor dependent, JGR would have kept him in the 19 car in Xfinity. After all, that was the main reason why Brandon Jones will stay in that ride for the foreseeable future. His father's company, Ream, is all but funding Christopher Bell's number 20 in the series and is keeping them a powerhouse within the garage. At some point in every driver's career, you see sponsors help out a little bit, and for Matt Tifft, he doesn't have the almighty dollar like pay drivers have featured for years. So the bottom line, Matt Tifft to Front Row Motorsports is a move that is getting too much criticism. Tifft is an overall decent top 10 to top 15 driver. He might not be the flashy young guy that takes home the trophies, but he knows how to put together results. And for a Front Row Motorsports team stuck in neutral, I think this is a great fit. Next season, however, I would expect a ton of growing pains, especially since the team is expanding to 3 vehicles and a brand new Ford Mustang. He won't be as bad as Kevin Conway, but a good season for Matt Tifft would be a top 30 points finish as well as a top 10 here and there. We'll see how this move shakes out, but it's the right move in the long run for both parties. So anyways, this is NASCAR Racing Fan 2015 signing out, and just remember, life's a beach, and then you drive.